to try my hand at making some more of this paper that I paper material stuff that I used in this keeper that I made in the last video I put out. And if you haven't seen this, this is called Fused Vinyl Keepers on my channel. These are Shannon Green's Fused Vinyl Keepers, and I decorated two of them for my granddaughters. And I made this material because I wanted something for a pocket in the back, and I did it with facing. Now it's old-fashioned facing, no glue on it, and it's this particular one is quite thick, but you know it's and sturdy, but this is what it looked like when it was done. I just put some tissue paper over it, some Tim Holtz tissue paper, a little bit of paper. That's I see here. But mostly it's Tim Holtz tissue paper. And paint, of course, which is because I wanted it to be close to the colors that were inside the keeper. But I, of course, I had scraps and I glued them on this ATC. I'm following Kylie Ku's positivity deck. And this card, it's not quite finished, but this will be my energy card anyway. So I'm gonna have another go with this. It's very sturdy. It looks to me like, you know, it will last a while, and it's flexible like material, although it's stiffer obviously than some materials, but it's you can put water on it. You probably can't see that. Maybe you can. You put water on it. Nothing happens to it. And wipe it off. So you could wash dirt off of it. So it, you know, might be fun to have around. And I think what I'm going to try and do is make enough that I can make a one of those little wellness bags that Gina made for her well-being bags, I think she calls them, she made for the teachers. And they exchanged fun things to put in them. So I think I'm going to do that, one of those. You know, just something small, nothing fancy. We'll see how it goes. My plan is this time, rather than the tissue paper, to use, some of Gina's beautiful feathers. These come in a planner set called New Feathers. And also I'm using Plush Possum's a bird set, spring bird set. And this lady, Plush Possum Studios on the internet, she gives away this stuff. She does a lot of work on it, but she gives away stuff. It's amazing. Beautiful things. And I really like the eggs and the color. I even like the lace. I thought that might be fun to have. I mean, I think you could put real lace on this, you know, no problem, and just put it on. But the idea is just to put matte medium. I got out this, the cheapest one I have. And I'm going to just go at it and fast forward, and I'll talk to you at the end, or I'll voice over or whatever. It is a real medium hog. It takes tons of this stuff, and then it's difficult to to get it dried properly, and you have to be patient with that. I let it air dry. I didn't try and speed up that at all. So, yeah. So this is just an old piece of facing that was hanging around. It's even dirty because it's been through the mills in my stash. And but I'm going to use it anyway because you're going to cover it up and you're going to paint over it and, you know, nobody's going to see that. So, I'll be back with the process and then I'll talk to you at the end. Okay, so this is the a stamp set of Gina's, and I put the feathers out, and then I thought, ugh, you know, I'm not sure I like it enough, so I stamped the stamp set on the tissue paper, I thought I'd try this. Oh no, don't breathe heavy. Don't even breathe because these things move like crazy. Oh dear. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So right now the plan is put these down and then put the feathers on top. And we'll see. We'll see. Again, I'll test after I've done that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put these down. And I don't even think you should watch half this. There's no necessity for you to watch this whole thing. So I'll come back when it's done. Okay, so where are we? So here it is, covered with the mother of pearl structure gel, and you can see the nice shimmer that it's given it. And I did try and iron it. It's a little flatter, but I was scared to put too much heat on it. I think it probably would have lasted. Given that I actually have to have a finished product here, I decided not to risk it. I put a piece of tissue paper. I ironed it on the back and I put a piece of tissue paper over that when I ironed it. So that's it. And now I'm going to take it downstairs and cut it and sew it. And the next time you see it, it'll be a bag. I hope.
Okay, bye.
So here's the bag, all finished. My sewing machine was not happy with it, I must say. And I think it's because it has more layers than the other pieces that I did. This stuff, I only have scraps left of it. But this was just tissue paper and paint. And so you can see that it's more flexible. It's got a lot more give to it. This has got paint and then two layers of matte medium where I glued the tissue paper and then the feathers. And then it has the structure gel on it, the mother of pearl finish on it. So it has several more layers and it is much thicker and much scrunchier. It feels like an old-fashioned raincoat, you know, the old kind of oilskin raincoats. So it's got an interesting, really interesting texture, and I suspect it's almost waterproof. I mean, not waterproof, but certainly water resistant. So you could put like a small set of watercolors in there and barrel brushes and maybe even a little spray bottle to take with you. And it would, if something spilt, it wouldn't be a big deal, you know. I think that's kind of fun. I have any idea what I'm going to use it for. Maybe that. But I think as a, the idea of making fabric, I think is fascinating. And I think you could use thinner facing and maybe lighter products like maybe napkins. Napkins and a lighter facing might be really, really nice. And then you know, my imagination tends towards maybe doing a little pocket on a plain pair of pants or something, or a lapel, covering a lapel on a jacket, you know, something to give a plain garment a little artistic flair. But anyway, so let's not forget what we're here for. This is all of the products that you saw here were the downloads from Gina's website, Gina B. Aaron's Designs website, and those are her stamps. And pop on over to her store. The links for where to find her are in the description box below. There's also a coupon there if you're so inclined. It can give you 15% off. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you want me to know you're here, give me a comment. I'd love to have you subscribe if you're interested. I'm creeping up, very small channel, creeping up towards 100. Yay! So I'm really actually excited about 100. But this is Gina's design team for May. And I made mixed media fabric, I guess I'm gonna call it. All right, folks. See you next time. Bye.